Hey PQI members, this is Jeremy Levy, director of PQI. What up? I'm so excited to tell you about all the PQI seminars that are being scheduled for the summer. To kick off everything, we have a distinguished inaugural lecture from Hideo Mabuchi. One of the things that distinguishes our distinguished lecture is the interview segment, which we held just yesterday. His life is fascinating. I didn't realize, for example, that he went straight from his PhD at Caltech to being a professor at Caltech. I mean, who does that? Aside from the academics, he has wide-ranging interests, ceramics and art and philosophy. We only had time to touch upon a few of these in his interview, but please check it out. The link is in the description below. So the Mabuchi lecture is really just the tip of the iceberg. As you recall, we invited a dozen distinguished speakers to our PQI 2020 event, which got postponed. So we've been working on developing a summer lecture series, which is basically in place at the moment. And what we're going to be doing is on Thursdays at 3:30 p.m., we're going to be hosting one of the speakers each week, coupled with two local speakers. So those who don't fit into the summer series will be giving seminars in the fall. So the format is going to be similar to what we'll be doing for Hideo Mabuchi's lecture, in that there's going to be a small curated audience on the Zoom call, and then the rest of you will be able to watch live using the YouTube channel, and you'll be able to ask questions in the chat window. So I also have a wonderful announcement to make concerning the Telluride Science Research Center. They are organizing a summer lecture series which covers a wide range of topics. Many of them are quantum and of course of great interest to the PQI community. Topics like ab initio design and control of quantum materials, enhanced functionalities and 4D and 5D transition metal compounds with large spin orbit coupling, electronic and magnetic properties of chiral structures and their assemblies, and quantum frontiers in molecular science. So all this is going to be happening in the summer. The talks are in the mornings, and registration for the summer lecture series has been made free to all of the PQI faculty and students. So all you need to do to watch or participate in any of these lectures, which will be posted on the PQI website, is to simply register at the Telluride site with your PQI account, and everything will be covered automatically. So finally, I wanted to call attention to a recent quantum road mapping effort, which is sponsored by the Optical Society of America Industry Development Associates. So this is a photonic-centric document that is really looking at how photonics can contribute to the second quantum revolution. So there are lots of really interesting graphics like this one, which covers major areas of quantum sensing, communication, and computation. And of course, what is needed to get to those killer quantum apps. There's also an assessment of what's needed today in 2020. There's a big emphasis on quantum sensing. So the number of venture capital deals is growing by leaps and bounds, as you can see from this chart, and governments around the world are investing heavily in this area. So this is one of my favorite charts, an inequality that says if X plus Y is greater than Z, well, then you need to worry. Of course, they're referring to the time that it may take to develop a quantum computer that's powerful enough to crack the current encryption schemes. X plus Y is not greater than Z just yet, so don't worry. So that's all for this week's edition of TLDR. Stay PQ engaged, everybody.
It is a-